Okay, let's talk about the CLEP College Algebra exam. And if you're watching this video, I assume you are preparing to take the CLEP College Algebra exam. And that is awesome because the CLEP program is an excellent way to save money and time if you are going to college. Again, I'm going to assume that you are because you're watching this video. Now, let's just talk about college algebra real quick. College algebra, for the most part, is going to be very similar to Algebra 2 in high school. Now, there could be a little bit difference there, but if you've taken Algebra 2 successfully, you should be in a real good position to take on that CLEP College Algebra exam. Again, if you pass this exam, you're not going to have to take college algebra in your college or university. That's going to save you money and time. So it is a worthy endeavor to prepare for the CLEP College Algebra exam. Now, there's another CLEP math exam. It's called CLEP College Mathematics. That's much more advanced than College Algebra. But anyways, what we got here in this video is a practice problem that you should be able to fully be able to handle if you are 100% prepared for the CLEP College Algebra exam. Of course, we're going to cover this here in a second. And but before we do, let me quickly introduce myself. My name is John. I'm the founder of TC Math Academy. I'm also a middle and high school math teacher. I've been teaching math for decades, and I've constructed a lot of math products along the way. One of the things I'm most proud of is my CLEP College Algebra Math Prep course. Okay, very, very comprehensive. Again, I've taught all these courses. So if you're looking for an excellent study course or study material, I'm going to leave a link to my CLEP College Algebra Math Prep course in the description of this video. Check that out. I promise you it will get you fully prepared to pass that CLEP College Algebra exam. But let's take a look at this problem here. And I'm going to give you a chance to, of course, answer it. And then, of course, I'm going to go over it. But here I have 2 to the 5th is equal to 32. Okay, so hopefully all of you out there know that 2 to the 5th is equal to 32. What I want you to do is to write this expression or this equation. I want you to write it in logarithmic form. Write it in log form, okay? So write this into logarithmic form. This is absolutely a topic that you're going to have to know very well for the CLEP College Algebra exam because we are dealing with exponential functions and logarithmic functions. So if you want to think about this for a second, pause video and go ahead and do so. But let's go ahead and take a look at the answer right now. Okay, so I'm going to explain this to you. And let's start off over here to the left. So here we have 2 to the 5th power is equal to 32, right? So 2 times itself 5 times is equal to 32. Now, looking at this, our 2 is our what? Well, we would classify the 2 as the base. This little number up here, 5, is the exponent. So this base to this exponent is equal to this answer, which is 32, okay? So 2 to the 5th power is equal to 32. Our base is 2. Our exponent is 5. And our answer is 32. So you need to kind of understand this right here. And I'm sure most of you do, because this is going to bring us over to this. Now, when you are studying logarithms, the main idea is exponential functions, i.e. things power functions, okay, or is closely related to logarithmic functions. These two here are inverses of one another. And the great thing about logarithms is that you can express a power as a logarithm and a logarithm as an exponential function. So let's see how this is done. So here is how you're going to, here's basically the rule, okay? So a base to the exponent, okay, as we're seeing here, some base to some exponent is equal to some answer. We can write this situation this way. So it's going to be log BAE. And my favorite saying, or one of my favorite sayings when I teach this stuff, is bacon and eggs, okay? So log bacon and eggs. Just go this way, okay? If you remember bacon and eggs, you will be good to go. So log BAE, okay? So, you know, bacon and eggs, you know what the B stands for, the A stands for, and the E stands for. The B is the base, A is the answer, and E is the exponent, okay? So again, log bacon and eggs. So let's go ahead and put this together now. And let's go ahead and kind of clear this up so we can focus one at a time. So you're going to write L-O-G, okay? We'll write our little base. Now, the base is going to be a subscript, okay? It's not going to be like this, log 2, okay? That's not what that is. You have to put that down as a little number. It's called a subscript down in the bottom right. So what is our base? Well, our base over here is 2, okay? We want to write 2 to the 5th is equal to 32 as a logarithm. So our base is 2, okay? Bacon and eggs. So now we'll go on to A. What is our answer? Our answer was 32, okay? And that's equal to the exponent, and our exponent was 5, okay? So that's what our exponent was. It was 5. So 2 to the 5th equals 32, I can write as the logarithm, log base 2, 32 is equal to 5. Now, let's take a look at this problem, just kind of an extra bonus problem. If you want to get your calculator out, and I asked you to evaluate log base 2, 32, okay, to find this, actually find the answer to this, well, our answer is going to be 5, but how do you use your calculator to actually do this? Well, on our calculator, you have two log buttons. You have this one here, L-O-G, and you have the L-N button. The L-O-G is actually log base 10. That's called the common log. And the L-N is really log base E. That's called the natural log. We don't have a log base 2 button. Okay, now I would like to have a log base 2 button, because if I did, I can go log base 2, 32. Okay, so my question to you is, how do we evaluate log base 2, 32? We know it's equal to 5. Well, this brings me to my final little bonus point here, is you need to know the change of base formula. Okay, so log base 2, 32 is equal to log of 32, okay, the common log. Okay, you can use your LOG, your base 10. You can actually even use your natural log here, but just go ahead and do this in your calculator, log 32 over log of 2, okay? This is how you evaluate log base 2, 32. It's called the change of base formula. Log 32 over log 2 is equal to, you just do this in your calculator, you'll see it will magically pop out this number 5, which of course you already knew that this was the situation, okay? So to work with logarithms and exponential functions, you know, kind of the most basic elementary thing that you need to understand is, how do you go from an exponential function and write that as a log function and a logarithmic function into an exponential function? This is one of the most basic critical things that you need to understand. And this is absolutely going to be on the CLEP College Algebra exam, okay? All right, so hopefully this little practice problem helped you out. I'm gonna suggest that, you know, you don't underestimate how challenging this program is. Even if you did pretty well in Algebra 2, you know, there is a ton of stuff that you need to review and be up to speed on. So, excuse me, you don't want to underestimate the opportunity here, okay? So I would definitely be studying as hard as you possibly can. Check out my CLEP College Algebra Prep course. I can tell you right now, I think you'll really, really like it. It will definitely aid you so you can be successful on the CLEP College Algebra exam. And with that being said, I definitely wish you all the best on all your endeavors in college, and certainly on the CLEP College Algebra exam. Thank you for your time, and have a great day.